So there's a lot of options that are available to you with your excess generation. Your excess generation, most retailers will provide you a feed-in tariff. That feed-in tariff can range between retailer and from one company to the next. So shop around for what best suits you. You can have power diverters. So power diverters have got the ability to reroute that excess generation instead of putting it into the grid, may go on into what's referred to as a dumb load. So a dumb load is commonly viewed as something like a standard hot water system. So you can start to heat up your hot water system with that excess generation, therefore not needing it to heat it up at nighttime from the grid. You might have and start looking at batteries as an option. So having that excess generation stored inside a battery cell, and then you consuming from that battery of an evening or in the morning, or to supplement your generation if it's not quite sufficiently high enough from your own consumption, you can consume from the battery and have that offset. Or electric vehicles, putting it into your electric vehicles, be it during the daytime, you can do time shifting. There's a lot of different things, and by default, if you're creating your own energy and you're consuming your own energy, then the side effect of that will be you're decreasing your consumption from the grid and in turn decreasing your bills. So the more you self-consume, understanding how and when you're consuming that power, trying to automate your home as much as possible, put things on timer, reducing your evening consumption, putting LED lights instead of normal incandescent globes. All these things are a holistic picture of trying to decrease your quarterly bill, because you're going to supply yourself with your own generation. A quality installer will give you the best recommendation based upon what your profile is, how you're using your power, and what you're likely to be doing it in the future. Really talk and communicate that with your installer.